Welcome to Recap King. In this video, we will explain Burnt. This movie tells the story of a chef who destroyed his career with drugs and diva behavior. He cleans up and returns to London, determined to redeem himself by spearheading a top restaurant that can gain 3 Michelin stars. Will he get a second chance to improve himself and succeed? Let's find out in Burnt. Burnt begins with the story of a bad-tempered chef named Adam Jones. Adam is seen on a bus, remembering the advice of his former mentor, Jean-Luc. Even though he was a talented chef, he had a black record of drugs in his past. As a result of this act, not only his career, but the reputation of the leading restaurant in Paris, owned by Jean-Luc where he worked before, was also destroyed. Adam then went to New Orleans to punish himself by shelling a million shells as penance. After going through hard times, he finally decided to build everything from scratch. He intends to develop his own restaurant and pursue a 3 Michelin star title. For that, he went to London to meet his old friend, Tony, who had worked with him when he was still in Paris. In London, Tony works as a hotel manager of the Langham Hotel, owned by his family. He asked Tony to be hired as head chef at one of his restaurants. Hearing Adam's request, Tony could only laugh at him because he knew Adam's past was very bad. Moreover, he currently has many enemies such as people he has harmed, and drug dealers who are still looking for him because of his unpaid debts. Later, Adam was seen visiting another friend named Conti. From his conversation, he learns that Jean-Luc has died. When tasting the food at Conti's restaurant, he immediately asked permission to meet the chef. He went into the kitchen and met a female chef named Helene. There, he arrogantly criticized Helene's cooking method, which he considered inappropriate, making Helene immediately hate him. After some time, while Adam was walking, he accidentally met an old acquaintance named Mitchell. In the past, Adam had harmed Mitchell by releasing rats in his restaurant so he might still feel a grudge against him. However, as it turns out, Mitchell has forgiven Adam and wants him to join him if he opens his own restaurant. To open his own restaurant, Adam hunts for a talented chef by visiting a suburban restaurant. He meets a young chef named David, who greatly admires him and loves his recipes. Adam compliments David's cooking and asks him to join the restaurant on the condition that he can stay at David's place temporarily. Adam cooks a meal for David and his girlfriend at David's apartment, but even though Adam is a famous chef, his cooking style is still outdated. A few days later, Adam met Helene again and invited her to join his restaurant. Remembering Adam's treatment when criticizing her cooking at that time, Helene refused the request and immediately left. After failing to persuade Helene to join him, Adam then meets a female restaurant critic named Simone Forth. Adam asks Simone to help him with an impromptu inspection of Tony's restaurant. The goal is that he can be re-employed by Tony. Sometime later, Simone came to visit Tony's restaurant. Seeing Simone getting out of the car in front of his restaurant, Tony was immediately nervous and asked the chef to make the best dish. But as it turned out, the food cooked by the chef was very simple and would not fit into Simone's criteria. In a state of urgency, Tony finally had no other choice but to allow Adam to cook in his restaurant. After Adam finished cooking the dish, Simone's order was immediately served. Then, as planned, she really enjoys her meal and saves Tony's restaurant from criticism. Later that night, Adam again persuades Tony by assuring him that he has changed. He asked Tony if he could be employed at his restaurant and promised to get a 3 Michelin star. Finally, after hearing his persistence and services, that afternoon, to save his restaurant from Simone's criticism, he agreed to work with Adam. The next day, Adam visits his best friend Reese, who worked together at Jean-Luc's restaurant in Paris. There, he criticizes the cuisine at Reese's restaurant for using modern equipment. Because of that, their conversation became heated, especially when Reese found out that Adam was aiming for a 3 Michelin star title. The last chef to be recruited is Max, a young man recently released from prison who used to work as a chef while in Paris. Max happily accepted the offer. Long story short, Adam is meticulously preparing for the opening of his restaurant. Starting from selecting food ingredients, room decorations, and every restaurant detail to suit his wishes. Finally, Adam's restaurant, named Adam Jones Restaurant at the Langham Hotel, opened, where he became the head chef. Meanwhile, on that day, Helene was immediately fired from her job. Turns out it was all Adam's plan so that Helene could work with him. Adam then offered to triple her salary to work with him. On Helene's first day on the job, the problem arose because there were 4 empty tables in his restaurant, which were the subject of news coverage by a reporter. Hearing this, the ambitious Adam became emotional. On that day, he became angry and criticized all the cooking of his chefs. He vented his anger by throwing plates and utensils in the kitchen while preparing a meal. After coming out to cool down, he went back into the kitchen and asked the chefs to cook perfectly without any mistakes. Seeing this, Helene did not remain silent. He criticized Adam because his menu did not match his outdated cooking style. The debate resulted in Helene being expelled on her first day on the job. However, the next day, Tony, the restaurant manager, came to see Helene to persuade her to come back to work. He asked Helene to understand Adam's angry temper. Adam's angry and arrogant nature was formed from his harsh childhood, especially without the presence of his parents. Sometime later, Helene accompanied Tony with modern kitchen utensils and asked Adam to adapt to the changing times. Adam agreed and started the busy restaurant again. The use of modern cooking utensils aimed at saving time and being more efficient in presenting new menus in the restaurant has paid off. The restaurant was running as Adam had hoped, where the visitors who came to his restaurant were satisfied. The news that had spread in the newspapers reached Reese, Adam's old friend. Adam's success turns Reese so frustrated and angry that he destroys his own restaurant. Day after day changed, where the cohesiveness between Adam and Helene was getting better so that the results of their food menu creations were in line with expectations. They often worked together to create new menu creations, until the seeds of love appear between the two. One day, Tony gathered all the restaurant waiters to give a briefing that a Michelin rating could come at any time. Therefore, Tony asked them to always be alert by telling the characteristics of the Michelin review team when they came to his restaurant. Some of the features are that they always come in pairs, order appetizers and desserts, and one of them will put the fork on the floor. So Tony asked the entire restaurant staff to cooperate perfectly, because the slightest mistake would not go unnoticed. That night, Helene came to see Adam and asked to leave the next day, because it was her daughter's birthday. Unfortunately, it turns out that Adam did not give permission so that Helene was annoyed, and vented her frustration in the kitchen. The next day, Helene still came to work with her daughter, Lily. Seeing that, Tony took the initiative to ask Adam to make a birthday cake for Lily. Although Adam initially refused, because Tony keep forced him, he was finally forced to make it. When Lily was accompanied by Tony, at a table in the restaurant, Adam came with a birthday cake for the little girl. While talking, Lily called Adam a fierce giant, but Adam remained friendly and calm so that Helene who saw him felt happy. Sometime later, Adam is invited by Reese to come to his restaurant. Adam was asked to bring a partner to quell his angry nature. Apparently, Adam brought Helene to accompany him. He unexpectedly meets Jean-Luc's daughter named Anne-Marie, his ex-girlfriend, and told him that her father had ordered her to give his personal knife to Adam, the person he thought was worthy of being his successor. After attending his friend's restaurant opening ceremony, Adam daydreamed in a market near his restaurant. Helene then approached and they told each other about their past. Adam said that his childhood was spent working in the fish market at that time. Then, after his savings were sufficient, he moved to Paris and was mentored by Jean-Luc to work in his restaurant. There, he met Tony, Reese, Max, and the others. However, one day, he destroys the restaurant's reputation, his personal life, and hurts his friends. After that, they left the market and returned to the restaurant. When going back to the restaurant, Adam is called by the drug dealer because he still has debt problems with him. Helene, who was worried, then looked for him. Beside the trash can, she found Adam sitting in pain with a battered face. Helene took Adam into the restaurant and treated his wound. Not long after, a restaurant waiter came in and informed him that diners had the same characteristics as the Michelin review team. Hearing this, Adam got up and went straight to the kitchen to make food orders regardless of his wound. Because it was Adam's dream to get an award from Michelin, his team worked together to help him prepare the dish. However, a few moments later, Tony came with an order from the visitor earlier. It turned out that the visitor filed a complaint because the taste of the dish he ordered was too spicy. Hearing this, Adam was shocked, especially when he found out that the food served to the visitor had been sabotaged by Mitchell. It turned out Mitchell has worked with Adam only as a revenge attempt to bring him down, because Adam had done bad things to his restaurant in the past. The incident had left Adam devastated and frustrated. He went drinking and came to Reese's restaurant drunk. Even there, he tried to end his life. However, the action was prevented by Reese. When Adam woke up, he immediately made breakfast for Adam in the morning. The best moment is how a friend is present in the most difficult times. This is because after Adam told him everything that happened, Reese actually encouraged him to get up immediately by saying that he was better than him. Even Reese or the other chefs still need Adam as a competitor to keep all the chefs motivated. When Adam was going back to the restaurant, he met a drug dealer who smiled at him in the afternoon. It turned out that all his debts had been paid by Anne-Marie, and just wanted to repay Adam's kindness and give her father's knife at that time. While observing the late Jean-Luc's knife, Tony and Helene came to his room. Tony informed that the visitor who filed a complaint was not from the Michelin review team, but only a software seller who happened to be eating. Hearing this, Adam immediately turned happy that he unconsciously kissed Tony. A few days later, two diners came to the restaurant. Both visitors have the characteristics of a review team from Michelin. However, when Tony broke this information to Adam in the kitchen, Adam's reaction was the exact opposite of usual. He told the chef to work as usual with cooperation and without pressure. Adam, who used to be angry, arrogant, and selfish, now manages the kitchen differently. Now, he is calmer and more confident in the abilities of his team of chefs. At the end of the film, Adam looks really happy, especially now that he has succeeded in achieving his biggest dream of getting a 3 Michelin star rating. The film ends. From this film, we can learn that, although there will always be a second chance, achieving it is certainly not an easy thing. Moreover, if the trust given to us is not used properly, we might not get it again. It takes a process and time for the people we've ever disappointed to trust our abilities again.